respected chairpersons, I should thank the organizers to put me in the opposite bench than the other speakers. But let me tell you that we are all friends. We are all friends. And one way, this lunch symposium will make them sleepy, all the audience, so they will not ask questions if I have blurted out something. Now, I am supposed to talk on pitfalls of PD in critically ill patients, not AKI, critically ill patients. Please underline that and just think. Okay. Now, is this true? Are there any pitfalls? And why is that PD is less in ICCU? Let me tell you, I gave a call to about 15 of my friends in different hospitals and asked them, whether are you practicing PD in critical care unit, in your critical care unit? All told no, and only one of my friend in airport told that he is practicing only to those patients who are poor. That means anything can happen to them, no problem, but he will practice PD in them. That was the only thing, Josh. Now, we all know common modalities now at this rate is CRRT, SLED, IHD and PD. PD, I put a question mark again. Here, Dr. Amit Gupta himself told that we should practice PD, but he doesn't practice in his unit. That's what he told also. So he has accepted. Let us introspect. I don't say we should not practice PD in critically ill patients. Let us introspect what is the cause for PD, drop in PD in critical care units. Think, how many of us are doing PD in CCU, except in government hospitals, again for financial reasons only. I don't think for scientific reasons they are doing. Second one is, what was in 1980? Let me tell you, 1984, we used to start PD only in critical care unit, not even hemodialysis, because we were worried about drop in blood pressure. We didn't have sophisticated machines, what we had now. So, and what is it in 1990 and what is it now? That's what we have to think about it. So now, if you see, most of us straight away decide about CRRT or SLED in these patients. Why has this been utilized as? That is what we have to think. And is this a reality? That is, PD should not be practiced in critical care? Or is it just an unfounded fear? It's a fear in me that should I start PD in a critically ill patient? Now, why this shift from 1980 to 2015? Now, there are many reasons why we have accepted other modalities than PD, and these are the pitfalls, I think so. One is, demography of the patients have been changed. We have now more sicker patients, and we have got challenging patients whom we accept for treatment. Second thing is better understanding of the critically ill patients. We didn't have critical care society in 1980s or 84. Now you have critical care society itself. So there is definitely better understanding. You have more and more old patients. We have better dialysis equipment, better monitoring, and we expect faster results. We don't want any slow result unnecessarily. Why this shift again from PD to CRRT or SLED? One is physician bias. I accept it. We are all biased that PD is not effective, and that's why we are not starting PD in critically ill patients. And there are not many studies comparing with PD. I'll be showing you something. Many studies are on CRRT and SLED. There are not many studies in PD. Urgency in starting treatment. Whenever there is an urgency in critical care unit, you don't go on operating and putting a soft catheter or something, but you would like to shove in a femoral catheter and start off the treatment. It's slower correction in PD, that is what is mattering in critical care unit. And there is no controlled correlation. That is, if I want to remove 500 ml per hour, I can't guarantee in PD, but I can guarantee in CRRT. And fear of infection and catheter malfunction. You go all the way and operate and put in a catheter and there it's not draining, you're in trouble. Now, problems in critically ill patients, again, CRRT versus PD. Hypotension clearance will be less in PD. Fluid overload, mild, okay, you can start PD. But in severe, I don't think we would dare to start PD. Acidosis, again, lactic acidosis would be a problem. hyperkalemia can be corrected with PD, but if it is severe hyperkalemia, we would like to go ahead and correct it rapidly with CRRT or SLED, requiring larger fluid. You know, in critical care unit, we are in a problem that suddenly you would see that they would have pumped in 200 or 300 ml blood, I mean, saline for hypotension without our knowledge. You want to remove it, you can't remove it on PD. There are other problems like bleeding tendency, control of blood sugar, malnutrition, and urgency in treatment. These are the ones which I find pitfalls for PD. Now, this is the main thing. Now, if you look, I did a PubMed search and compared CRRT and PD in ICCU. If you look, this side picture, which shows that there were so many studies till now comparing PD and CRRT, last 10 years, the number of studies in PD has come down, and last 5 years, further PD studies have vanished. That means that even in scientific world, they are not accepting PD as a modality in PD, in critically ill patient. This also forms this. Now, Indian study. There's an Indian study from George, from Trivandrum. It's an elegant study, but in a small population. And overall, their conclusion was, it is cost effective and it is not inferior to CRRT in critically ill patient. But you know, please look at that disclosure. That study was sponsored by Baxter. So obviously, there will be some bias in that study. So I would not accept it. And it was further criticized elsewhere that this study was underpowered and performed using both peritoneal and CVVH clearances below which one would consider optimal. So obviously this study is not totally scientific. Second one is pediatric study. Peritoneal dialysis is, again, they have found that it is not inferior, neither this thing. And there was one study which they had to abandon PD and when comparing PD and CRRT because of inferior results and high mortality in these patients. So, and one latest is from our group, that is Dr. Rajiv Venigari, Chakravarti, they all met and they have come to a consensus. And if you look at it, PD falls last in most of the recommendations except in intracranial diseases.
I'm sorry for the interruption.
Okay, 1 second. So concluding pitfalls is no belief in PD. PD less practiced in ICCU is biased. More trials in CRRT, lesser studies in PD, lesser desirable results, less controlled therapy, not in first recommendation, limited scope, less suitable in many sick patients. I don't say PD is contraindicated.
Yeah, so you will use it, but not as the first recommendation.
Not as
the first. Questions from the audience.
Yeah.
Amit will start as soon as he goes back in his unit PD, right?
No, I think your arguments are okay, but you realize a country like India,
I know,
where not all patients can go to Apollo Hospital in Chennai. There are patients who are being treated in Mofussil towns with snake bite or say malarial acute kidney injury. There, PD is the only available scope. So we need to train our doctors. We've forgotten the art of peritoneal dialysis, and we're not training our students in peritoneal dialysis. And this is something that we need to take care of, because otherwise you can't attend or treat many of these patients who require dialysis in some form.
Do you want an answer for this? I didn't say that we should not practice PD. I said the reality. What is the state now?
So I think the point is well taken that in the government setup there is still training for PD, but in the private setup where a lot of nephrologists are getting trained, we are facing the problem. Yeah.
20 years ago, I had a young man who was very ill. His blood pressure, I remember, was 70. I immediately put him, we didn't have any SLED or CRRT at that time. I put him on PD. He gradually recovered, put him back on hemodialysis, transplanted him, and he's been with me for the last 20 years. And attribute his life to peritoneal dialysis in the ICU setting, acute ICU setting.
So I think we thank KC for the debate which he has brought up.
Sir, one.
And okay, question.
We do both CRRTs and PDs.
Good.
In critical care, and both actually, unbiased way. Acute PD is definitely good, except in patients with a severe sepsis. And except in severe sepsis. And there we chose the CRRT. And we have options of both. We can choose either of them. Despite that, I feel that patients with a neurological deterioration, especially those with strokes and post-cardiac surgeries, and some cases, the PD will be better, especially those with an altered sensorium. The same. We feel comfortable with that. And CRRT in severe patients, severe sepsis and hypertension. There, we are comfortable with both, either of them.
Thank you, Bhushan.